We did a makeup actually on him, on the artist. God, what was the name? But he had all these diagonal lines, and he had very rough skin and textured skin, and I was like, because I hate using silicone foreheads because they just they stick out too much, and it just doesn't work. I've done it like in Bicentennial Man on Robin. I didn't use a forehead. I'd use stipple on his forehead, and anywhere I can. But on Embeth, I used a very thin silicone, and it worked really, really good. But it has to be very thin, and sometimes it doesn't work. And I wanted to use the transfers for aging different parts, like the crow's feet and certain areas. And we found that the top lip and the crow's feet and the forehead worked unbelievable for the age makeups. And then using the silicone for the rest of it. Neck, cheeks, chin, eye bags. But it was on the film during it. I was like, what am I going to do for his forehead? And then Brian Sipes said, well, what about using a transfer for the forehead? And I was thinking, it won't work. It's too big. It's wrapped around. You know, it's made flat. Just won't work. So next day I came in, and he goes, what do you think? And I'm looking at one of our people in the shop. I go, what do you mean? And he goes, it's the forehead. And I looked, and he had a transfer piece on. And I couldn't see it. And I went, oh, my God. Amazing. So that's how the transfers came about. The interesting thing on the top lip was when we did silicone appliances, it with the cheeks, when they smile, you get these weird wrinkles in it. So by using the transfer, which you see in the pictures, it's so thin and stiff, but they can still act in it. It's still sculpted with little tiny wrinkles, but it's just paper thin. And by gluing that on there, then they work beautifully, no problem. I'll also show you on Kate how we did the little crow's feet. The forehead comes down. I would stipple into right onto the material, the transfers, and the stipple would make it all just blend into each other and wrinkle, and it was so smooth. Because you know those shots of Kate and the close-ups and Benjamin, I mean, you know, they were like, they didn't even tell us they were doing that shot. You know, it's like this going out. The compliment, it was a very difficult film to work on because David Fincher isn't the easiest person to work with. I knew that going in. I'd worked on a film with him before. But I knew he was the only one that could pull off the film. You know, he knew the digital. I knew he would make me and do the absolute best makeups I could do. Can you still hear me?
Yes, thank you.
I knew he could still, you know, pull the best makeups out of me, and I knew it was going to be a terrifying film to work on. And of course, it turned out much worse than I ever thought. But it's one of those films where you're on the film and you're going, I have to do this film. It's once in a lifetime. You know, I hope it works. And luckily it did. I mean, I had 2 weeks of tests where we did a lot of makeups, and I'll show you the tests. Kate, her makeups turned out pretty good the first time. They're very close, and we went with them, the 85-year-old. And it wasn't until 1 year later to the day that we shot her scenes in the hospital. So I did the test makeup 1 year before, and then I didn't get to do any other test until the first day of shooting when they did the close-up. So the compliment you got from David Fincher was, you better make sure it's like that every day for the next 2 weeks. That was the compliment I got, which was pretty good. So, and then trying to do that for 2 weeks, that makeup, and match it every day in the age spots, and you know, unbelievable, but it worked. So, and then to be able to work with Kate Blanchett on makeups like that, it's just, you know, incredible. And Brad was great. The only problem I had with Brad is he wanted to try everything. We did that first makeup of what's his name, Wyatt, the artist,
Andrew.
Andrew, yes. Andrew Wyatt is what we use, where he really wanted those lines and everything. And we did a fatter, more realistic character makeup on Brad, and it looked ridiculous. Because his face, it just, you know, if you're doing some weird movie, but it just was over the top, and it, no. So we did it, of course, doing Brad as much as possible, of course, because he has to age to that. And then we did the age makeup, and I really loved what we did in the test, which I'll show you. But then, you know, Brad, he wants to try thinner, less makeup, you know, less sculpting, even though he wants all this texture. So he said, I want the forehead, I want to do cheeks and the forehead material, the transfers. So we did cheeks, which I never liked at all. It was just didn't work. It was too shiny for me. And just to show you how difficult this film got, at some point the shop fell apart. I had to take it all over myself. Someone would come in the middle of the night. I had sculpted Tilda Swinton's age makeup. Miles had finished it off. Beautiful. Someone would come in the middle of the night and re-sculpt the cheeks, because they thought they knew better at the time. So I come in the next day, and I'm just like, what the? And Miles is furious, and then that person wasn't there, and I said, re-sculpt him. So he had to re-sculpt as best he could on the pieces. Things like that happening. Someone decided when we did Brad's cheek transfers that they should be dark orange, and because they thought it would work better. And you know, I'm on set and I get the pieces we do on the first day, and no makeup in the world could have covered those pieces. And then they're yelling at me on set, and I'm going, look, I didn't do it, you know, and I've already corrected it, and tomorrow the new ones are coming with the right color. And you know, luckily that saved me. I could have been fired at that point. They were so mad, but nothing I could do about it. And then the new makeup, of course, worked great. The color was perfect. So it was quite an interesting film. Someone had, because I was in charge of the makeup, but people were trying to do things on the side in the other shop that existed before. And they like had sculpted Queenie's makeup, old age makeup, and it was really bad. I mean, it just was horrible. And luckily we did the test, and I went to David and the producer and said, look, this isn't working, you know, it's horrible, can I re-sculpt it? And they said, yeah, go ahead. So I went home for Christmas for 2 weeks, and Christmas Day till 6 a.m. the next morning, I sculpted the new age makeup, the 72-year-old, which you see in the pictures. So luckily that happened. And there were still some other things that I wasn't able to redo in the film, but it worked, and you don't notice it, luckily, and most of it worked out great. So those are some of the problems of big shops and you know, things that can go wrong. So, but I want to bring all this up just because, like I said, the best way, this film, and I can't wait to do another film, is to do these makeups using transfers and silicone, the combination. It's, for me, I think it's the only way to do it. The only way you can do foreheads realistically. And so we're going to see the clip now.